Well, that's my new profile pic done, since I utilise some particular iOS apps that I got recently, and then do a new profile pic. As well as doing a new profile pic, I thought I'd utilise it on the new custom gamer pics for Xbox, and I thought I'd put that on that along with that as well. Since there's a particular kind of trending app that's out recently, I thought I'd take advantage of them using my profile pic that I just took and maybe use this particular app. I wonder what it looks like with a smile too. Oh my god! It's a vlog.
Hooked on the feeling, I'm high and believing.
Yeah, even though that, funny which I actually watched Guardians of the Galaxy this past 1 week, since it was on the Gold TV, on Bank Holiday Monday, I decided to watch it, even though, I don't have the particular headphones though, even though it's not plugged in, but I had that song for quite a while, before Guardians of the Galaxy came out. I just haven't got around to watching that film, well, in Marvel films as it is, because I don't watch that many Marvel films. But yeah, it was just a good film overall, even though it's quite a coincidence since a particular video game for Guardians of the Galaxy came out this past week, as well as the new film will come out next week, which will be good though. Anyways, I am Stephen Walker and CT Films, it's a vlog. So, what videos I did this past 1 week? I'm just the one particular video this past 1 week. Even though I did say kind of briefly on my last vlog that I might take a week hiatus. Combo breaker on the particular videos I've been doing, because I've been doing like 2 videos per week lately, and I was doing so well, but no, I had to ruin it by either taking a week hiatus lately. And I found a particular something this past 1 week which was £20 worth, which was this PlayStation 4 media remote that I found in my local CES. So I got it for £3.50, which is not bad buy, even considering there was not much videos about on YouTube. So I was like, why not? Easy search and whatnot. Even a quite coincidence, when I published the video, when someone commented, who was not a particular, who hasn't subscribed to my channel, actually commented saying, ah, this is great though. It convinced me to maybe buy one. It's like, yeah, that's nice, thanks. Even though I doubt they'll watch this video. But other than that, though, yeah, thank you for commenting nonetheless. But yeah, overall, there was a nice video to do. And this past 1 week, even though I didn't do another one, so I just did the one particular video this past 1 week. Even though I've got videos on the pipeline as it is. But it's just that I'm struggling a little bit lately. But I've got videos planned, though, nonetheless, even though I might not do 2 videos per week at the moment, but we'll see. We'll see on the outcome though. But yeah, so that's the kind of video that I did this past 1 week. So for this vlog, I thought I'd show you guys something that I picked up lately. Even though I quietly briefly mentioned on my last vlog, even though I thought I'd quickly mention also that since purchasing and upgrading my PS3, because I've been saving up a bit lately, even though I thought I'd save up again, even though I was a bit unsure on what, you know, video games to get this past 1 month, but there was not much things interesting, so I thought I'd save up for a particular something, let alone I'll be picking Mario Kart 8 at some point, which I'm looking forward to, so I'm saving some money towards that as well. But I thought I'd get this while because I got an offer, is what I'm trying to say. But yeah, I picked up this, which is a Nintendo Switch Pro controller, which I actually purchased this along with because I got it from Argos, you see, because they were doing a particular offer at the moment. You can spend a certain amount of money, and basically you get like this nice voucher, which is quite nice, which is a £5 voucher that I'll put towards something, which I'll mention about in a bit. But yeah, I just picked up a Pro Controller, Nintendo Switch Pro Controller, because might as well get one, even though I would consider waiting until it's a bit cheaper, because when I got the Wii U and Pro Controller, I actually got that for around £25, which is not bad buy, even though they go quite a bit now, they're going up in value again. But it was nice to get that though from a Wii U, but I might as well get this even though I'm sure wait until it's cheaper though. But there are certain games that are coming out for the Nintendo Switch nonetheless, and I thought I'd get one now. So it's over and done with, like the offer that I picked up in the end, which is good though, and take advantage of the offer as well. But yeah, it's a nice controller overall, here it is in the flesh. But yeah, it's a nice controller overall, I mean, liking it at the moment, because even though you know, for the past month or so, you know, since I got my Nintendo Switch, I've been quite comfortable using the Joy-Cons separately, because I was using the controller grip. Sure, the controller grip is actually quite good, nonetheless, but it felt more comfortable, you know, having it separately, let alone laying like this, you know, with the Joy-Cons, and it's, you know, can just do like an armrest and just play like this, and... You know, it's just taking all the advantages like that, and it's really comfortable nonetheless, and you can sit in really cool positions and playing it, though, is what I'm trying to say. But you get what I'm trying to say, it's comfortable nonetheless, but having an actual controller as well is not that bad also. But what I'm trying to say is, though, it's still good nonetheless, and it says you're picking up one of these, but it's good, though, having one of these as well. And it's really comfortable, so to say. So yeah, I'm just giving out my quick thoughts as it is. Even though that to me does feel comfortable nonetheless, because it feels like, because then the grip things feels like a PlayStation 4 controller, if he was, you know, playing a PlayStation 4 controller, but he was still a Nintendo person playing Nintendo still, and it does feel like a GameCube, you know, these grip things, which does feel really comfortable in the hands. Even I notice, because I know they don't do analog... control, you know, triggers like they do on the GameCube, but it still feels good nonetheless on the triggers. And the thumbsticks are good, like an Xbox 360 controller and Xbox One controller, so I feel right at home, because I do like that method when it comes to thumbsticks, actually, because it's more natural since, you know, since I got an Xbox 360, it just feels so natural with that controller alone. I actually prefer the Xbox One controller and Xbox 360 controller nonetheless. Not just in PlayStation in hands. I didn't particularly like the DualShock 3, but I do like the DualShock 4, though, because I do like that, though, because it's a bit bulky and whatnot. But other than that, though, I'm enjoying it nonetheless, let alone when I was playing Zelda Breath of the Wild, for example, because I do switch consoles, knowing me, and switch platforms, and it was... somewhat easy to adjust, let alone switching from Joy-Con to Pro Controller. It does. I'm getting my words mixed up, but you get what I'm trying to say. It's like when I switch from Joy-Cons to Pro Controller, it does feel comfortable and feels natural when you switch in between. But when you switch from different platform, it does feel a bit awkward though. For example, about what I was saying about Breath of the Wild, because when I play certain games on my Xbox and then switch back to this, and they had to get used to the control schemes, you see, when it comes to certain games, and well, even on the God Zelda, but you get what I'm trying to say in general, if he was one of those people that switch in between consoles. But they should really get a button mapping for Zelda, that way it saves me. But it was easy to switch, though, nonetheless, if I was playing some on my Xbox and I'd go back on my Switch and then play something else, you know. But it was easy to, but they should really button map for Zelda, though. But I didn't mind, though. It was easy transition when I played different consoles, what I'm trying to say. Even I only had, the only slight issues that I had was basically the D-pad can be a bit, but then again, I might have not saying a faulty one, so to say, but I've been having problems with the D-pad, though. Mainly for Tetris, since I haven't got many games for the Nintendo Switch to test it on. I have played Tetris and we're using the D-pad, and I noticed some accidental presses when I accidentally press it twice or three times. I noticed that when playing the Tetris demo, so I had some problems though. But it would take advantage though, if he was playing like a fighting game, for example, he was accidentally double pressing it. Maybe that's a good advantage when you're playing fighting games, but when you're playing, let's say, Tetris, though, it can be accidental presses when doing certain things, because I do, hard drop, you know, if he was playing Tetris, you know what I'm talking about, where you hard drop so many times, and I tend to accidentally, accidentally press it twice, is what I'm trying to say. But I'm enjoying playing this with Tetris, though, but I'd rather play it with the Joy-Cons, though, nonetheless, even though it's best played in handheld mode when you're out and about. It's one of those sort of games, puzzle games, you can just play out and about, let alone playing on the TV and the Pro Controller as it is. Just what I'll make my quick thoughts on that, let alone, You know, it's still good nonetheless playing this on the TV for games like Zelda and whatnot. But if he was playing like simpler games, you might have a disadvantage other than the D-pad issue that I had with Tetris nonetheless. But yeah, that's my quick thoughts overall on the Pro Controller. I'm enjoying it though, even if I haven't got that much games. But I'm looking forward to Mario Kart 8 though, and when I play this though. And then I can just take the take up the Nintendo Switch with the Joy-Cons all charged, and then when I'm out and about, then I know that my Joy-Cons are charged in case I wanted to play anything in particular with the Joy-Cons, let alone having it separately. And if I ever do find someone to play with, so to say, you know, at least the Joy-Cons are charged so I can play Mario Kart 8 with someone if I wanted to. So it's all charged, and when I'm at home, you know, playing on by myself and playing with the Pro Controller and playing Mario Kart 8 and whatnot. So yeah, it was good to take advantage of the Argos offer that was happening lately, and I can save a few pounds off, because I was planning to use this towards and gain some eShop credit, because you can get some eShop credit in Argos, even though I was a bit unsure, because there was a bit of a small print, you know, it's like this and that, and I couldn't properly read it, love my dyslexia in general. But I actually went in store, as soon as I got this, I went into store in Argos the other day and asked about it, and I can actually get some eShop credit or Xbox Live credit if I wanted to, and take a few pounds off, which is good. So I'll utilize this for eShop credit, even though I'm budgeting as it is lately, because even I'm planning to get something for next month as it is, even though I had to save up quite a bit for next month, because I would like to get a certain something for my PlayStation VR. That's a bit of a clue there, if that's coming up next month. But I would like to get that though, even though there are some things that are coming up next month, but I would like to save up towards getting that though, just for clicking mention. It would be a nice video to do, because I would like to purchase that though from a PlayStation VR as it is. Anyways, that's another thing for another day. But overall, yeah, I forgot what I was... the reason why I would like to put this towards some eShop credit is so I can get Minecraft, though. Because as soon as Minecraft for Nintendo Switch was announced, it was going to come out next month, which is a bit sooner than later. I thought it was going to come out, like, in the fall. But, so I was like, oh, I'm out of budget and stuff, you see, is what I'm trying to say. But also, I should be able to get it nonetheless, even though, at the end of the day, if my mum says it's okay, it's okay. Let alone, budgeting is what I'm trying to say. But yeah, I'm looking forward to getting Minecraft and Nintendo Switch if it all goes to plan, because I would like to save a few pounds off utilising this while I get some eShop credit in Argos. But it'll be a good game overall, because I mentioned about it in my last vlog, let alone my Nintendo Direct thoughts as it is, and it will be a really good definitive version for the Nintendo Switch, and portability wise, and since I got a Pro Controller now, it can be nice to play this, and then once my Nintendo Switch and Joy-Cons charge, I can just take it out of the bag and just play it like at mum's and whatever, because I need to get some more games. Because again, as I mentioned time and time again, since the Nintendo Switch came out, I would like to tend to get some more games from the Nintendo Switch on certain games I already own, like Skyrim, for example. That is tempting, even though I got Zelda Breath of the Wild, it's a great game. There's still more stuff I need to do on that game, nonetheless. It's just that lately, since I got Skyrim on the Xbox One, it's just that I've played so much on the Xbox 360, I couldn't get back into playing Skyrim. So I do not know to get on the Switch also, let alone the portability-wise as it is. But it's just like, is what I'm trying to say. But I'm looking forward to more games on the Switch nonetheless. It's just a bit, hit and miss, let alone certain games are coming out at some point. Which is good, though. I'm enjoying the Nintendo Switch nonetheless as is. That's kind of my brief, month thoughts, because people have been doing like, oh, this is my first month of the Nintendo Switch, and how's it getting on? Oh, it's great, I'm enjoying it, you know, for the past month, you know, just for get that out of the way also. So it's what I've been up to this past 1 week. I had an alright week overall, even though that some things have been putting me off a bit lately. Mostly people, so to say, is what I'm trying to say. Even though, again, like I said, I had a quite good week overall. I got my pro controller, so I'm happy. Even though I've been having some off-putting things with me, lol, and people as it is. Because, long story short, last weekend, lol, the Easter weekend as it is, there was a Comic-Con that happened in my local area, and someone who I know went, and she did a vlog on her channel and all that. And I watched that video, and I thought I'd compliment her on the video, because I messaged her on Facebook complimenting the videos was, I would have go, but there's like certain people that I know that I met online, but it's a bit awkward. Like, I'm like, you know, awkward and socializing and all that BS as it is, if you know what I mean. It's how I am, all my mental issues as it is. But what I'm trying to say, going off topic, you know, it's just that I complimented her, you know, and all that, and she didn't reply. And then the day after, when I briefly looked to check to her channel again, and she reached up to a milestone, 300 subscribers, and I was congratulating her on that, and she didn't reply back. So just things like that, and lulling people as it is, just put me off a bit lately. Because I've been having that lately, little trust issues, even though yesterday in general I was such in a particular mood and all that, even though I've been having like social problems as it is, it's trying to make myself not attention seeking away, if you get what I'm trying to say. It's just, it's hard to say the high, if you know what I mean. Just, it's really, you don't understand how hard it is to say hi, let alone replying to people as is. I don't mind replying to people that I'm comfortable with, is what I'm trying to say. Even though I'm just having mental issues, it is, and trust issues and all that as is. Even though last week or the week after, I forgot, I've recently been to the doctors, even though I've been reducing my medication a bit. And it's been put me off a bit lately, and some other things as it is, which I won't say. I'm trying not to explain too much about my mental issues as it is, but I'm just not saying dealing with other stuff as it is. It's just I'm having problems as it is. Well, I should be thinking to myself, I should be real lucky with what I have today and all that, and I should be happy with who I am, but I can be just a miserable git as I am. It's just how I am, and it's just, people don't understand, it's just another thing as it is. But I won't rant on too much as little than complaining as it is, as YouTubers will do with their YouTube videos and whatnot, if you get what I'm trying to say. But I know I complain about YouTube as well, you know, I can be complaining about YouTube as it is, but I won't talk about that, I'll shut up about that. So yeah, we'll wrap it up here then. So yeah, what videos I'll be doing next week then, Mario Kart 8 will be coming out next week, even though there are certain things that are coming out next week, because like the Prey demo is going to come out next week, which I'll have a try. I don't know to do some gameplay of, I'm not so sure, even though I'm not particularly much into scary games, even though it's not that scary in a way, it's like Dead Space scary, but we'll see though, even though I'm interested though to play it though, but I'm not so sure to do some gameplay though. But there are some stuff that are coming out next week, which I'm looking forward to, and we'll even finish off the end of this month as it is. But yeah, I just want to mention about that, so I might just do the one particular video next week, even though, as I mentioned, I'm struggling videos as it is, little, and I should be making videos nonetheless. I'll enjoy making videos as it is, little, and this vlog, I forgot to mention, this vlog as it is, it takes my thing, takes some things out of my chest, even though that I do, and talk in a positive attitude, but it does take things out. Stress relief is what I'm trying to say. So I enjoyed making these vlogs overall, nonetheless. Anyways, I really ramble on too much. So yeah, that's some vlog for you guys. Hope you really enjoy this video and watch it to the end of understanding. Understanding. There are people out there, is what I'm trying to say. Sorry, I don't want to rant too much. But yeah, Ren, so yeah, that's some vlog for you guys who watch this video to the end of understanding. Anyways, I'll show up and let you guys get on with the rest of your day. And do not forget to follow up on my social medias, what I'm up to. And yeah, I'll just let you guys get on with the rest of your day. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.